Hey guys, what's up? Today I'm bringing you a tutorial on how to create this this simple little Twitter widget in honor of the Twitter logo redesign. I just made it when I was bored and I figured I'd bring a tutorial on it. It might run somewhat long because I like to talk a lot and because it's not really making a whole interface, but it's like it's multiple UI elements. Anyways, I'm gonna clear everything and get started. Let me just create a new document, 700 by 700. And I think I just made it 70 by 70, which is my bad. Okay, and just fill it with a really light gray in the background. I'll be using 6E's for the color. That's a little too dark. So I'll be using F5, F5, F5. And then I'm just gonna go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise, set it to Gaussian, Monochromatic, and for the amount, put 0.5%. And now, into actually making the thing, you're going to want to right-click on your rectangle tool, the shape tool right there. Click the rounded rectangle tool. Right here, on that little arrow, right next to the custom shape tool, click that. Where it says unconstrained, scroll down and select fixed size, and set the width to 400 pixels and the height to 200 pixels. And then, when you click, then it will automatically have that shape for you. And you might have accidentally done it in inches. So if you did that and the shape was way too big, then go right here. It will probably say IN and just type in pixels manually both times, and that'll fix that. Then right here on this shape, we're gonna double click to bring up the layer style. We're going to go to, first we're going to add a gradient overlay, and we're going to click here, the stopper right here at 0%, we're going to change the color to F9, 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 and over here, we're going to change the location to 20%, and change the color to FC, FC, FC. Okay, then you're going to add one thing that I like to do first is go to view. It will probably have extras checked right there, and deselect it because it will add this little outline to your shape that isn't really there. And since the outline does look a lot better, we're going to want to add that ourselves. So we're going to click the stroke, set the size to 1. And set the color to a dark gray, and the color that I'll be using is 97, 97, 97. Yeah, maybe a little darker, 7A, 7A, 7A. But that's just up to you. I'll stick with my original one. Okay, and the last thing we're gonna add is a drop shadow. The opacity we'll set to 22. The distance will be 3, and we'll keep the size at 5. And then I want to rename that shape. I'll just name it background. No, main shape. And then I'm going to hit Control A to just select the whole thing, grab my move tool, and click this icon right here. And the one right here, and that will center our box. The next thing we're gonna create is the little header. So we're gonna get our rectangle tool. Make sure you don't have the rounded rectangle tool. We're going to right here, where it says it has the different shape options. Select the third one, which is subtract from shape area, and sort of draw that right around there. I didn't really like where I drew that, so I'm going to get my pen tool. I'm going to hold down control and click on the line of the rectangle, then hold down control again and click on the top 2 points. And you're going to want to hold down shift when you click the second one. And just use my down arrow key to move this to where I like. That looks good. I'm going to clear the layer style. I'm going to double click on that to change the color. And the color that I want to use will be 00BDF3. And then there's like an issue that will happen if you try to add a gradient overlay. Say like I want a black to white, it like the black will go down to where we drew that rectangle shape. So to get rid of that, the only way I know is right click and hit rasterize layer, and then it will, you know, get rid of that for you. And before I move on, I want to rename that shape to header. Now I'm going to go to that gradient overlay we just clicked. Make sure it's set from black to white, 90 degrees. The opacity I'm going to change to 26%. And I'm going to change the blend mode to overlay. Then I'm going to add an inner shadow. I'm going to change the blend mode to normal, the color to white, and I'm going to set the distance at 2 and keep the size at 5, and then I'm going to go back and change the opacity to 39%. Okay. The next thing I want to add is an inner glow. Keep it at screen if you want. Opacity, 19%. Color, white. And the choke, I'm going to crank all the way up to 100 and move the size all the way down to 1. Then I'm also going to add a bevel and emboss. I'm going to set the bevel, keep it at 100% depth. I'm going to set the size to 0. And I'll change the opacity of the screen, the white, to 28%, and of the multiply black to 21%. Okay? And then the last thing I'm going to do is add a stroke. And I'm going to get the stroke, I'm going to change the size to 1. And the color, I'm going to select sort of like the darkest color down here on that bar. Actually, what I'll do, I think you have to close out of the layer style menu, then do it again. There we go. That will give us the color of the background of that shape, but we want it darker than that, so I'm going to push it down and make it, I'll go with 00668B. Okay? Now you want your rounded rectangle tool again. I'm going to zoom in to make this a little more accurate and sort of draw out that little button that we had at the top. Oh, first, you're going to want to go back to that little arrow that we used earlier and select unconstrained. And now we're going to want to go and drag out that little button. And that looks about the size and everything that I want. So I'm going to zoom back out again. And go ahead and change the shape color to 00C4FF. I'm going to add a gradient overlay. I'm going to change the blend mode to multiply and the opacity to 10%. And I'm going to go here, I'm going to click on this white color stop at the beginning, and And I'm going to change the location to 85%. Now I'm going to add an outer glow. The color will be white. The blend mode will be overlay. And where is it? We keep the opacity at 75%, keep the spread at 0, and change the size to 4. And actually, I'm thinking that we're probably going to want to lower the opacity of this to around, 38%. Maybe even lower, 28. And then we're just going to add another stroke, size 1 pixel, and the color will be 008363. Actually, that's the wrong color. It's probably, it's not 6-3, it's B3. Okay? And that color looks a little too dark, so I probably changed the color of something else. I messed up there. 008-3-B-3. Okay. I'm not sure what happened. And you're going to want to rename this to, button. Normally, on real Twitter, that button would be used for writing a tweet. You'd click it and a little pop-up menu would appear. Anyways, to add the avatar, I'm not going to actually go ahead and add an avatar. I'm just going to select a dark gray as my foreground color. I'll use 5E, 5E, 5E. Get my rounded rectangle tool. And hold shift and drag out a little square where the avatar would go. You're going to want to also grab your move tool and scoot this in about that far from each edge. Okay, if you were really designing this for a real app and all, you'd probably want to go in and measure the distance, but we aren't, so I'm not going to do that. I'm also not going to walk through making the text or even make the text because, text is really easy in Photoshop, so I'm not going to waste my time explaining that. Alright, so the next thing you want to do is right-click on your Shapes tool, select the Line tool, set your foreground color to EA. Make sure the weight is at 1 pixel. You might want to zoom in here and just draw a line from one side to the other of your shape. If it adds a layer style for you, you want to right click and hit clear layer style. Now you want to duplicate that layer right there and change the color to white. Grab your move tool and just click the down arrow key once. And now select these two layers and hit control G to group them. I'm going to name the group divider. And you're going to want to scoot that up to around there. Okay. And then I'm going to want to add those little arrows that you use to move back and forth from the tweet. So I'm going to right click on the line tool and select rectangle tool. Then I'm going to draw out. Actually, first I want to change my foreground color to E7, and I'm going to draw out a rectangle. The height is important, try to make it about as high as I'm making it. The width won't be that important, and you'll see why in a second. Next thing you want to do is grab your pen tool, hold down control, and click here. And on one of these points right here, you're going to want to click on it to make it disappear. And hold down control and click on this one, and then drag it so that you make a triangle about that wide. And we're doing this because, as far as I know, Photoshop doesn't have a default triangle shape. Now grab your move tool and just move your triangle to right around there. Duplicate the triangle with Control J, or you can drag the layer onto the new layer button. Hit Control T, right click, and hit flip horizontal, and just drag it down over there. Select the two arrows, hit Control G to group them, and rename the group to arrows. And that's about it. The arrows, like, they look a little too big and not quite centered, so you'd probably want to spend more time on this if you were actually making it. You'd probably add some icons right there for the writing, maybe retweet, reply, and favorite, and then the text and the avatar. But this tutorial was just so you guys could understand the layer styles, so hopefully you enjoyed it. I'm sorry it ran a little long, and bye.